Hi, I'm Sapphire. Did you know by the year 2050, we'll need to double the amount of food made on Earth to feed everyone who will live on this planet? That means we will need a lot of people with jobs in agriculture. Agriculture is the science of farming. That means raising crops and animals that can provide food for humans. While I'm sure you know about people who are farmers and ranchers, there are a ton of other very important jobs that help make the food we eat every day. One of those jobs is an agronomist. Agronomist is a person who helps farmers grow the best food possible to feed you and your family. Today, we're in Ulysses, Kansas, talking to an agronomist that works at CropQuest. CropQuest is a company that helps farmers identify and fix problems in their crops. CropQuest works with farmers in multiple states, and its headquarters is in Dodge City, Kansas. Let's take a look at a day in the life of an agronomist. Let's go! Let's meet Brandon, an agronomist at CropQuest. Brandon, can you tell me what you do in your job?
An agronomist is a scientist that's an expert at raising food. We call those crops. I like to describe what I do as being a plant doctor. Farmers hire us to do weekly checks from the time they're planted to the time they're harvested. Kind of like checkups. You know the checkups you do with your doctor?
Yeah, I get it. Checkups aren't usually too bad, unless they're shots.
I know, right? Besides the checkups we do, we get calls from farmers because they can tell something's wrong or they need help fixing their crops. Kind of like when you have to call a doctor when you're sick or injured. I heard you recently broke your foot. Did the doctor run any tests?
Yeah, he did. He did x-rays to see if it was broken. Unfortunately, it was. I was on crutches for 6 weeks.
Well, just like the doctor ran tests, I'll run tests to see what's wrong and then come up with a plan to either fix it or keep it from getting any worse.
Okay, that makes sense. Today we're in a field of wheat. Can you tell me some of the tests you do when the wheat is sick?
Absolutely. Better yet, why don't we teach you how to run the test? That way you can see what it's like to be an agronomist for a day.
Heck yeah. Do I get to wear a lab coat and a stethoscope?
Heck no. But you do need a more appropriate wardrobe. I gotcha.
All right. Now I'm ready. Let's go.
Let's go.
Brandon and I visited a couple of fields to take a look at the different crops. We took nutrient samples from a field of wheat. We took samples from two different places, one part where the plants looked sick and another part where they looked healthier, so we could compare the differences.
We're gonna pull a soil sample and we're gonna do a tissue sample. Put it here between the rows, and then you just step on it. See how it just goes down? Mm-hmm. It'll stop. And you pull it back up. We'll just put it in the bag. Yeah. Yep. Go until it stops a little bit more. There you go. Pull it back up. There you go. Okay, and we'll flip her over. Press that core out. Cool. So we're pulling tissue sample now. So we'll take the flag leaf.
This is the flag leaf.
Yep, that's the flag leaf. Just keep pulling a few more of these. Yeah. Sweet, all right. There we go. Now we'll go to the bad spot and pull the bad ones. We'll call her good. That'll be enough. So like if we were at a younger growth stage, if it's small enough, we'd just take off the whole plant and put it in there. So that way they could sample it. We're good on this one.
Then we rode to an alfalfa field, where we used a sweep net to figure out what insects are living in this field. Some insects are good for the crops, but others can damage the plants.
I want you to look at this through the microscope. So right here is a spotted alfalfa.
Okay.
Oh, what the heck?
You see how he has all those spots on his back?
Mm-hmm.
That's what a spotted alfalfa it looks like.
That's cool. Brandon enters his data through an app on his phone. Being an agronomist is a job where you don't have to sit in an office all day. And I really like that.
Well, were you surprised at all the things I do?
Yeah, for sure. I really like the sweep net. That was cool. Who knew there were so many different bugs, and some of them are actually good for the plant. So, what do you do with all the information you gather? And what the lab will tell you about the field?
After I finish my visit and I get the test results back from the lab, I meet with the farmer and give them my recommendations. Together, we decide how to solve the problem. I might tell the farmer they should add a nutrient or fertilizer to improve the soil, sort of like when a doctor says you need to take vitamins or some kind of medicine. Or I might suggest that the farmer uses a pesticide to get rid of the bugs that are bad for the crop. I really enjoy helping my clients. I visit with most of them every week, so you really get to know them and their families, just like your doctor gets to know you and your family. I want my clients' crops to do well, because if they do, that means I'm doing a good job, and so are all my colleagues at CropQuest.
All the stuff we've done today reminds me of doing experiments in science class. So I guess an agronomist should like science, right?
Right.
So what else could a kid like me do to get ready for a job like this?
I always recommend students to get involved in their FFA program. I think they have a lot of activities that would help you prepare for what you're going to study in college. Your high school might also have ag CTE classes that would help you get well prepared.
I'll have to check those out. So what other fields do you work in?
Hop on, let's go check some baby corn.
Baby corn? Wow, that is baby corn. How tall will it be?
A lot taller than we are.
Whoa. Brandon, you know so much about being an agronomist. Did you go to college?
Yep. I grew up around farming, and I knew that if I had a family one day, our family farm wouldn't be big enough to support us. I went to Garden City Community College after high school, then after I went to Kansas State University to study agronomy. The summer after my senior year at K-State, I did an internship with CropQuest that let me work with an agronomist to get hands-on experience. I loved all the variety that came with helping lots of different farmers. It seemed like a job where you'd never be bored. After my internship was over, CropQuest offered me a full-time job, and I've been here ever since.
That's really cool. What else do agronomists do besides helping farmers take care of their crops?
Some agronomists work for seed companies, which produce the seeds farmers plant as their first step in raising a crop. These agronomists advise farmers which seeds they should buy depending on the kind of soil they have, the weather in their area, how much water they have, and so on. I considered going into this kind of job, but after my internship, I really knew I liked the challenge of figuring out what's wrong with crop. If you're considering a career in agronomy, you should really do a hands-on internship while you're in college to help you figure out what you like best. CropQuest actually has internships starting after your freshman year of college.
Doing an internship sounds really awesome. I like that your job lets you help so many other people, just like a doctor.
Yep, just without the shots.
I'd like to thank Brandon, all the farmers I got to meet in Southwest Kansas, and everybody at CropQuest for helping me learn what it's like to be an agronomist. They play a big part in feeding the world. Be sure you visit HirePaths.com to learn about other careers in agriculture, as well as other high-demand jobs in Kansas. Until next time, this is Sapphire signing off near Ulysses, Kansas for Cool Careers. Have a great day.
Episode 15. Take one.
Let's meet Brandon, an agronomist at CropQuest.
I forgot to write.
Brandon, you know so much about being a hold on just a minute. Hold on, guys. Okay, wait, okay.
That spraying is too odd, huh?
Which one?
Oh, you did. I thought you were being sprayed.
Because we did, we sprayed.